Hello, I'm Mathilde Ruffnacht, the author of shopncook software. I'm going to show you today how to import your supplier's price data into shopncook pro software. First, you need to export your data into CSV format, that is comma separated values. A CSV file looks like that. The values of each column are separated by commas. You can also use tab-separated and semicolon-separated values. If you have an Excel file, you can easily export it to comma or tab-separated format by selecting Save As in Excel and selecting CSV or TXT format. Some suppliers give also files with fixed column width. You can also import them directly into shopncook pro software. I go to the File menu and select Import Supermarket Data and select the file with the price of the supplier that I want to import. You are given the option of importing the price data as a new supermarket or to add the data to an existing supermarket. Since it is the first time we import the prices of this particular supplier, I select Import as New Supermarket. Here, you can input information about the new supermarket. It is important that you input at the minimum the name of the supermarket, that is Suma, and the language of the articles, here English. We can ignore for now the shopping list and ordering information tabs. They will make the subject of another tutorial. The software has correctly recognized that the file is in CSV format. I click OK. Here you can see the two first lines of each column of the file. The first line is a header in our case, and I select to ignore it so that it is not imported as a product. Next, you have to indicate to the software what is the content of each column. The first column is the category name, the second the brand, the next one is a product ID, the article name, then we have the product description that I ignore, the size of the article, and finally the price of the article. We can ignore all the other columns. Select also Match automatically articles with the database so that the software tries to link the article to items in the database. I click Import. Here is imported data. On the left, you have the product categories. I click on the first category, Fruits and Vegetables, to display its content. The first column is the article name, and the second shows the corresponding item of the database. The articles in black have been linked with the main database. The ones in red are not, and you have to do it manually. I show you how to link, for example, mango juice. Mango juice does not exist in the database of grocery items. Click on the database icon next to it to add it. I select the category juice, select to add it after lemon juice, and select to have it preferably by volume units instead of weight unit in the shopping list. Click OK. Now, mango juice has been added to the main database and the article is linked. Now I'm going to show you how to link carrot juice organic to the database. There is already an item carrot juice in the database, but not an organic one. If you don't want to make the distinction between organic and non-organic carrot juice, you can just link it to it. There is another carrot juice organic just below. You could also link it to carrot juice, as you can have several articles linked to the same grocery item. You don't need to link every article, but only those you use. When you are done linking, click OK to save the supermarket. You only have to do this linking work once. After that, updating the price information can be routinely done in a couple of minutes. I'm going to show you how. I have a file with new price data from the same supplier. Like before, I select Import Supermarket Data from the File menu and select the new file. I select this time to import into the supermarket that we created before. Check the file format has been correctly recognized and click OK. Like before, you have to indicate what is the content of each column. However, this time, you can ignore all the columns that you don't want to update. If you wanted only to update the price information and the corresponding size, you would only need to indicate the columns with product ID, price, and article size, and ignore all the other columns. You need now to indicate how to match the price information with the correct article. The software can recognize the articles by matching the product ID, the barcode, or the article name. The product ID and the barcode are usually good choices. The article name is not as good a choice, as often you will have articles with same names from different brands. I ignore the first line to skip the column headers and click Import. Here it's done. The price have been updated. That is all for importing price data from your suppliers.